name is Sofía Neira. I am 16 years old and I was born in Bogotá, Colombia. I came to the United States when I was 6 years old and I've been here for 10 years now. Music is a huge part of my life. My parents actually met in the music field. They were in the same music show and they ended up falling in love. And I was one of the products of that, love fest. And ever since I was a baby, I've been babbling, my mom says. Musically, I've always been very musically inclined. So it's all thanks to my parents. Music is something that has brought us very close as a family. It's something that we have in common. So I feel like that is a huge part of the bond that we have as a family. My brother, my dad, my mom, and I, we're all musically inclined. I've known ever since I was a little kid that no matter how big or small my problem may be, they were always going to be there for me. Whether it was my brother, my mom, or my dad, I knew I had somebody to count on. I remember in one day, it was a normal day. I went to school, I was in elementary school, and when I came back home, my mom and my dad sat me and my brother down. By the look in their faces, we can tell it was not something good.
Cuando ya les contamos a nuestros hijos, entonces mi esposo les habló y les dijo, bueno, yo quiero contarles que tenemos algo que decirles, algo importante. Y mi hijo mayor pudo entender que algo serio estaba sucediendo. Sin embargo, él estuvo muy atento, escuchó con atención todo lo que le dijimos y al final, después de haberle dicho pues, que me han diagnosticado el cáncer de mama, él me toma de las manos, me mira y me dice con su seguridad, con esa mirada que nunca olvidaré, me dice, mami, ¿tú crees que te vas a morir de cáncer? Olvídate, tú no te vas a morir de cáncer, tú estás bien.
I looked at my mom at that moment and I realized that she was very calm. Although she was trying to keep herself together, she was very calm. She wasn't crying, she was fine. But I could tell in her eyes that it was difficult for her. I was very scared when I heard the word cancer because I was small, but I always associated that word with death. Something that comforted me a lot though was my brother's attitude. He was very calm and collected and he told my mom and encouraged her that she wasn't gonna die because this cancer wasn't strong enough to bring her down. So my brother's attitude just comforted me and helped me to stay strong.
La mente me estaba diciendo todo el tiempo, wow, te vas a morir, pero también venía a mi mente también la palabra de Dios, lo que me decía, pero bueno, pero si Dios tiene el control.
Throughout the whole course of my mom's chemotherapies and all of the treatments that she was going through, I never saw my mom cry. I never saw her break down in front of us. She was always very strong. Although I did see her getting weaker, she was always very positive. When my mom got cancer, not only did she get cancer, but the family itself felt as if it was getting cancer. We were always there for her. We were always there to support her. Whenever she was down, we were down. Whenever she was happy, we were happy. It brought us together as a family. It made us bond even more than we were before.
Bueno, pues también lloraba porque no era de palo para no llorar, ¿no? Siempre tenía que llorar, así que yo me fui caminando y llorando y preguntándole a Dios, bueno, ¿qué pasa conmigo? ¿Qué va a pasar conmigo? Ya no le preguntaba por qué a mí, por qué me pasó a mí, ya le preguntaba era para qué me estaba permitiendo pasar por esta situación tan difícil. Y Dios me mostró algo maravilloso y se lo voy a contar porque es una cosa que me impactó mucho. Dentro de mi corazón, dentro de mi interior, sentí que Él me hablaba y me decía, ¿tú has visto la mariposa? ¿Has visto la mariposa de dónde viene? ¿Cómo sale la mariposa? Y yo pensaba, sí, la mariposa sale, viene de un gusano que es muy feo, ese gusano es feo, de la oruga, ¿no? Entonces me dice, sí, de ahí sale. Tú ahora estás en ese gusano, pero luego vas a abrir tus alas de tal manera que vas a verte más resplandeciente que ahora, que antes, vas a ver. Entonces cuando yo sentí esa confirmación en mi vida de que lo que yo estaba viendo era un temporal, que eso, yo no me iba a quedar así, que no me iba a quedar ahí, que no me iba a morir, que no, Dios me estaba confirmando que yo eso lo iba a pasar muy rápido, muy fácil. Entonces les cuento que cuando yo regresé a mi casa, yo ya llegué de otra manera, llegué contenta, riéndome, mejor dicho, con una energía que cuando abrí la puerta de mi casa, mis hijos y mi esposo me miraron y me dijeron, mami, ¿qué tienes? Te ves diferente. Y yo, ¿qué tengo? Me dice, no, te ves resplandeciente.
When her hair was falling off, for example, she actually made fun of it. She would laugh at the fact that she was getting bald, which gave me humor, and it encouraged me to stay strong with her.
Tuve que usar pelucas, tuve que ponerme turbantes. Enfrenté todas esas etapas de feas que ninguna mujer desearía pasar, porque las mujeres nunca vamos a querer vernos calvas, parecernos a un extraterrestre. Siempre queremos vernos bien, pero aún en medio de esa fealdad, entre comillas, yo me veía bien, me sentía bien. Y pude reflejarle y proyectarle eso a mis hijos y a la gente que estaba a mi alrededor.
Throughout the whole process, my mom was very strong. As I said before, I never saw her cry. Through every chemotherapy, although she was getting a little bit weaker, every time she would get back up even stronger than before. So that helped me a lot. That also kept giving me hope. I never saw in her face the fear of death. She was never afraid of dying. She knew she was in God's hands, and that also gave the whole family hope.
Yo pude llegar hasta el final de las quimioterapias, que entre otras cosas les cuento, mucha gente lo pasa. Llega a la mitad y se puede morir. Pero Dios siempre me guardó, me cuidó. Y al final, en la última quimioterapia, fue maravilloso. La misma doctora estaba sorprendida de ver mi entusiasmo. Siempre que llegábamos allá con otra amiguita que estaba en las mismas condiciones que yo, éramos la más entusiasta, nos reíamos en medio de todo eso tan difícil que es ese ambiente, y nos dieron el carnet de que bien, terminaron, felicitaciones, todo estuvo bien. Así que yo en esos tiempos y en todos esos tiempos que estuve viviendo, pude sentir el para qué. Dios había permitido que yo viviera esta situación. De hecho, ya me estaba confirmando de que yo había podido pasar las quimioterapias, exponiéndome a tantos efectos secundarios fuertes que tienen esto, que, como les digo, uno puede morirse. Pero Dios me pasó, como dice en una de sus promesas, y pasarán por las aguas y no se ahogarán, pasarán por el fuego y no se quemarán. A mí me pasó eso, y a mi amiga le pasó lo mismo. Así que vivimos una situación de victoria. Y hoy en día, bueno, Dios me usó todo eso para yo poder llegar ahora a apoyar a mujeres en la misma situación que yo viví.
One of the happiest and most hopeful moments for us was the last surgery that she had, where she had to have one breast removed. It was the happiest day because we knew that it was over, that she didn't have to go through any more chemotherapies, through any more radiation. She defeated the cancer, basically. Although there was still risks, she still had to be very careful with the things she ate, with everything. There were still risks, but we knew we had passed the hardest obstacle. Through this situation in my life, I realized that God doesn't just put you in a bad situation or for no reason. He has a purpose behind absolutely everything. My favorite quote says, it's not a dead end if it takes you somewhere you needed to go. My mom came out of this even stronger than she was before, and she did wonderful things after overcoming the cancer. Until this day, she's been helping women everywhere in my church, everywhere she's met women and even men who have cancer, and she's helped them, not only giving them tips as in what to eat, what not to eat, but also giving them hope and giving them strength. And she's done something beautiful out of something terrible, basically.